Hello! To record acoustic guitar, you can use different microphones and different setups. Today we want to compare three different microphone types and check out how they sound. My name is Gabriel and today Kfir Ochaion will play the guitar for us. Before you hit record, always make sure that the guitar is in tune and check the tuning regularly between takes. Plus, new strings never hurt. The room you're recording in will heavily influence the sound of your recordings. For most recordings, especially at home, it is best to find a space that sounds rather dry instead of having a lot of reverb. Adding reverb is easy. Removing unwanted or bad sounding reverb is rocket science and can definitely cause headaches. Your living room is probably a good choice, as your couch and bookshelves provide absorption and diffusion. Our studio here is definitely on the drier side. Before we listen to the different microphones, keep in mind that the position of the microphone is extremely important. A guitar sounds different from every angle. The best sounding microphone will not work if it is in the wrong place. As a general rule of thumb, listen to the guitar from different spots. Usually, a spot where it sounds good to your ears is a great starting point to place a microphone. First, we will try a dynamic handheld microphone. You might already have one of these at home. Although a dynamic microphone would usually not be my first choice for this application, you can get absolutely great sounding results. Let's find a suitable position. I think this is a good starting point. Let's move it around until we find the optimal placement. As you can hear, changing the position of the microphone even slightly alters the sound. Nothing good comes from rushing it. So take your time. Record a short bit and always listen back before you make a decision. I really like this position. What do you think? Leave us a comment if you would have chosen a different one. Next up is the small diaphragm condenser, also called a pencil mic. It is well suited to capture the natural sound of your acoustic guitar. Again, let's see where it sounds best. I really like this position. What do you think? Leave us a comment if you would have chosen a different one. Next up, we have the large diaphragm condenser. Compared to the small diaphragm, it has slightly less attack and overall a fuller sound with an excellent bass response. Let's give it a listen. Thank you. Things really get interesting when you have a couple of mics available. A multi-mic setup allows you to achieve different tones in post-production. Not only can you combine the different signals to taste, you can also make use of the stereo field. Let's check it out. We hope we could help you to make an informed decision. Comparing sounds is difficult and you overestimate what your brain can do. You can't remember how it sounded 3 minutes ago. So let's compare them all in a supercut. A big thank you to Kfir Ochaion for joining and playing for us. Check out his channel, he's really good. If you have any further questions, please let us know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, until next time, and make yourself heard.